Welcome back to Psych2Go. My name is Tina, also known as Tina, at the YouTube channel, youtube.com/fortiswallflower. And today the topic is bitchiness. Is it nature or is it nurture? This is an article written by Risha May Ortiz. So in modern day society, there are many ways that people define bitchiness. There's like the good bitch and bad bitch, but all in all, what exactly does bitchiness entail? And so in this article, bitchiness was defined as indirect aggression. Indirect aggression is the aggression we don't want to get caught for. There was a study done by Dr. Valancourt, who is a psychology professor at the University of Ottawa. So in the study, there were two groups of women. Each woman was paired with another woman, which was either a friend or a stranger. And so half of these women were interrupted by the conservative confederate. And so the conservative confederate was a woman who was just very simple and presentable and very proper. The other half of these women were interrupted by a sexy confederate, whom was a woman that was just very sexy and promiscuous and ultimately more attractive. And so when both of these groups of women were interrupted by the conservative confederate or the sexy confederate, it was found that women found the sexy confederate to be more bitchy than the conservative confederate, regardless of the fact that both confederates were interrupting the women in generally the same way. There's another study done in which women were shown three photos. And of these three photos, one of them included a thin, sexy woman, a heavy or more larger sexy woman, and a third photo of a woman that's very conservative and presentable. And so when these women were shown these photos, they were asked which woman would they allow to show their boyfriends or allow their boyfriend to spend time with. And what this study concluded was that regardless of weight, women did not want to introduce their boyfriend or allow their boyfriend to spend time with women whom they find attractive and sexy. Which then concludes that women are threatened by, disapprove of, and punish other women whom they find attractive or sexy regardless of weight. So another psychologist named David Buss at the University of Texas found that women are more likely to insult other women based off of two things. Firstly, the slut factor, and secondly, physical appearance. The slut factor is when women gossip about other women saying that she is more easy and more promiscuous and essentially more sexually active. And physical appearance is when you make fun of or like nitpick at someone else's physical appearance. Buss argues that women do this because women who are quote-unquote slutty undermine the goals of women with long-term relationship goals. So another conclusion was made by Agustin Fuentes, chair of the Department of Anthropology at the University of Notre Dame, who said that physical appearance is an important way for women to respond to each other. Another conclusion was made by Anne Campbell, a psychologist at Durham University, and she said that young women use indirect aggression towards young men more because it is the most socially acceptable way to compete. So after having heard all these conclusions and studies, what do you think? So do you think that indirect aggression is the proper way to define bitchiness? Or do you think that there's a better way to define it? Let us know in the comments below what you think is the best way to describe bitchiness or what you believe bitchiness entails. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you would like to subscribe to the channel, please do subscribe at Psych2Go. And be sure to follow them on Facebook, Twitter, and Tumblr. And if you'd like to see more of me, you can go back to my channel at youtube.com/fortiswallflower. Thanks for watching. Bye.